So tonight we are off to Passions on the Beach. It is just about a quarter mile away from our condo, Oceana. It is beach dining, so the tables are literally in the sand, and it's supposed to be a really good spot to see the sunset, and the food's supposed to be pretty good as well. And I like that it's so close, so we're able to just walk. We don't have to take the car tonight. And that's it. We'll let you know soon. Wonderful, thank you so much.
Right, you're gonna have the best view.
Alright, so just got back from dinner at Passions on the Beach. Everything was really good. I had the Chilean sea bass. It came with wasabi, mashed potatoes, and snap peas, and a soy ginger glaze. It was really, really good. I was pleasantly surprised that the mashed potatoes actually had some wasabi flavor. I kind of was thinking in my head it was gonna be a little dull or not that flavorful, but it really had some good spice to it and I really enjoyed it. And then Kevin had the filet and that also was really good. It was tender, it was flavorful, like no complaints at all. For dessert, we did key lime pie and that was really yummy as well. Couple things that I wanted to mention. So we had 6 o'clock reservations. They open at 6 o'clock. If I did it again, I would pick 6:30. We originally picked 6 because the sunset was around 7:05. But when we got there at 6, there were still quite a few beachgoers that were there. So next time I would just do it a little bit later just so there were less people on the beach. It certainly didn't hinder the dinner, but just for next time I would just do a half hour later. Since we were a little bit early, we got there about 6:10, we had a drink at the bar. What I want to note about that is at the whole restaurant in general, Passions on the Beach charges an automatic 15% service charge gratuity. That's fine. But they don't tell you about it. So when you're at the bar, they just say, okay, you owe $22 and you give your card. They don't tell you that there's a charge. So more than likely, they're getting double gratuity. We had a drink there a couple nights ago and we had an itemized receipt. So we knew that it was included, but most people probably don't, so they're probably, you know, really over tipping. Same thing with dinner. Our gratuity was included at dinner, and then you're able to leave more if you want. Also, the bathroom situation there is, since you're on the beach, it's kind of a fancy porta potty. You are able to go across the street to the Manor, Amsterdam Manor, and in their lobby you can use their bathroom, but that's something to note about that. There was music. He didn't start playing until 6:45, and I thought that was kind of weird since the restaurant opens at 6. And he took a long time in between songs. So in between songs, he probably rested for anywhere from like 4 to 8 minutes, depending on the time. So I thought that was a little weird. I would have preferred music that was constantly playing. But the music was good. It was a violinist. According to the bartender, it rotates. So depending on the day of the week, it could be a guitarist, a violinist, or a saxophone player. So it was really good. I would go back again and I give it a thumbs up.